I'm Edward Warfield, and I'm honored today to interview Marina Aslayan, the CEO of SmartLinx. Welcome, Marina.
Thank you, and thank you for having me here.
Before we dive into SmartLinx, can you tell us about your career and your journey leading up to your present role?
Sure. For the past 20-plus years, I've been a consultant and a business leader with a focus on helping companies solve real-world business and technology challenges. Before I came to SmartLinx in 2012, I was president of Altitude Strategic Consulting, where I was focused on helping technology clients achieve operational excellence across the board, anywhere from strategy to product concept and idea creation to product development and financial management. Prior to that, I was a member of the executive team and a head of the global professional services and product quality units at Sparta Systems. Sparta Systems is a global provider of quality management solutions. Throughout my career there, and now in my current role at SmartLinx as well, I've been a big proponent of aligning the company's technology vision with its business strategy. This has been the growth catalyst for multiple companies I've led, and I'm making a similar hands-on integrated approach here at SmartLinx.
Can you tell us about SmartLinx and your vision for the company?
SmartLinx is a leading provider of workforce management solutions and is helping post-acute and senior living organizations successfully navigate today's workforce challenges. SmartLinx helps organizations with one of the biggest challenges that they have, and that is labor management. Up to 80% of our customers' cost is attributed to labor. Managing that cost effectively is an extremely difficult task. It's a constant balancing act. SmartLinx helps organizations to optimize costs where they can recognize to higher margins. Those extra dollars then are invested in better care for the residents. We specifically serve those that care for our most vulnerable population, post-acute and senior living health providers. These people are doing one of the toughest jobs right now, especially with COVID, and need solutions that will keep them and their residents safe. Our software ensures that the right amount and mix of staff are scheduled at the right times to optimize coverage within the organization. Long term, we are committed to transforming the post-acute care and senior living industry, ensuring providers and their teams are empowered to deliver exceptional care through technology.
Can you provide us an overview of some recent announcements and the potential, how these initiatives are benefiting your customers?
Of course, I'm very excited about some recent developments that we have and we just announced and launched, as well as some of the upcoming ones that I will be sharing with you. So a handful of new projects in the works, all addressing really timely and critical issues within the industry today. We've equipped SmartLinx Time Clock with a new add-on capability so that the employees checking in and out of work every day are as safe as possible. This includes a touchless time clock that lets employees enter their time with a QR code on their smartphone, rather than having to physically touch the system the way they used to. We've also come out with an add-on that conducts thermal scans and can detect if any employee has a heightened temperature before they start their shift. In addition, we recently announced a preferred third-party commercial lender, Ascentium Capital. They are a national provider of business equipment financing, leasing, and loans. Ascentium Capital will offer fast and flexible financing options to help our clients advance their business goals. Technology investments can be cost prohibitive for many senior care operators who are facing mounting staff challenges and keeping residents and employees safe during COVID-19. By offering customized financing options like zero down payments, plans and low introductory payment options, we can take the burden out of technology purchases so the operators can actually focus on safety and high quality care. I'm also very proud to announce a SmartLinx 5-star predictor, a tool that gives our clients the power to proactively predict and improve their 5-star quality rating to meet the compliance standards set by the Centers for Medicaid and Medicare Services, which is CMS. COVID-19 is making more important than ever for skilled nursing, long-term care, and post-acute facilities to meet compliance requirements to protect the safety and well-being of residents. In addition to identifying staffing issues before they manifest, the SmartLinx 5-star predictor calculates each facility's projected star rating for staffing in real time. It also delivers warnings when the facility staffing falls below their desired star rating requirements. I'm also excited a few announcements that are coming up in 2021. Early next year, we will be launching the state-of-the-art touchless smart clock designed to counter the spread of infectious bacteria. It's powered by IoT, cloud, and SaaS technologies. Employees will be able to quickly and automatically punch in and out of work through QR codes sent to their SmartLynx Go application on their iPhones and Android phones, without having to interact with any high-touch devices. In seconds, their temperature is also read and all their punch information is automatically sent to the SmartLynx Workforce Management System, making it easier for managers and staff to manage their schedules. In 2021, we also be launching a solution aimed at home healthcare workers. According to recent EY report, home health employs about 1.5 million people in about 12,000 agencies. Home healthcare is considered less expensive than a skilled nursing facility or assisted living or retirement community. During the pandemic, occupancy rates in all of the facilities are dropping from roughly 90% plus to about 75%. We expect this trend to continue into 2021, given that the pandemic is still around. And our mobile application, SmartLynx Go, can be configured to support home health. We'll work closely with our customers to best support their staffing challenges as we expect this. It will also help our clients to continue to provide a full continuum of care using a standard application, which is SmartLynx.
So let's talk a little bit about the competitive landscape. How does SmartLynx how do you compare with the other workforce management solution companies out there?
Sure, I can think of many different ways that we differentiate ourselves, but I think for the purpose of today's conversation, I would like to focus on the top three. SmartLynx is a problem-solving company. We collectively just truly care about our customers, and it starts with me. I personally care about each and every customer that we have. One of the reasons I care so much about our customers is the fact that I also used to be one on the receiving end. And I was a customer of many vendors. So I understand what client needs and expectations truly are. We internalize this customer-first attitude and build it as part of our organizational culture. It's not simply the customer is always right, but we understand that our role is to support our customers and make them successful despite of the circumstances. We also bring in parallel subject matter expertise. We've been in business for over 20 years and have learned this industry inside out. We have a very tenured team, and between having access to so much knowledge and believing in the success of our customers, that is where our true differentiation lies.
So many of your customers are in the acute and long-term care industry. How are you responding to COVID-19 and how are you supporting your clients?
Helping long-term and acute care facilities navigate COVID-19 has been one of our major priorities this year, obviously. And since the onset of COVID-19, we've been committed to supporting our customers, many of which care for senior residents who are particularly vulnerable to contagious diseases like COVID-19. We made it our mission to do everything we could, from providing PPE to developing the tools they need to meet changing CDC guidelines and federal regulations and support their safety. As I mentioned earlier, we recently introduced the SmartLynx touchless time clock, which will also support our clients by reducing the risk of spreading the virus. The employee time clock is the most shared device for most post-acute care and senior living organizations. It typically sits by the door, and basically every person that enters the facility touches it. By introducing the touchless technology where employees can use QR codes on their mobile devices to punch in and out, the new smart clock will lower the risk of diseases transmission through contaminated hands. We are continuing to work with our clients on their evolving needs during COVID-19, and we look forward to supporting them however we can.
And how did you approach the pandemic internally? What some strategies? How have you dealt with it with your staff?
Sure. It came fast and furious, and I'm sure we weren't the only organization struggling with the decision-making process at first. What do we do? Do we continue in the office? Do we shut down? How do we create a safe environment? I would say, similar to our approach to customers, one of my priority was to make sure all SmartLynx employees feel supported and engaged during these difficult times. We were all learning as we went along. My goal was to create a sense of calm while also making sure our staff knew SmartLinks is taking the pandemic very, very seriously. I decided to close our offices early on in the pandemic to maintain safety and work closely with our HR and technology teams to make sure our employees were equipped to continue working safely and comfortably from home. We've heard from some employees that they feel connected, that they feel more connected than ever as a result of the remote team events we've hosted. Anywhere from informal happy hours to company-wide town halls, we continue to stay in touch, not only me, but the entire executive team with the rest of the organization. Our goal is to keep employee morale high as we approach the end of the year and continue to navigate our new normal.
And so what advice would you provide to other leaders who are navigating through difficult or uncertain times?
As a leader, one of the most important things that one must do is constantly push the limits. You need to constantly go after things you believe can and will be possible. Don't ever expect the status quo. Challenge yourself, challenge your teams to think outside of the box and adopt a can-do attitude. Try to figure out ways to get things done instead of caving to the reasons you cannot. It's always easy to say we haven't done that before, so we can't do it. But you just need one reason to say why you can. And usually it's the belief. If you are complacent in whatever it is that you are doing, not thinking outside of the box and pushing the limits of yourself or your team, you are going to be stuck in the status quo. You constantly need to think about the opportunities that you wouldn't normally entertain and use them as inspiration to reach new levels.
And so what are your future goals and plans for SmartLinks?
I am looking forward to our continued focus on maintaining our leadership position in post-acute care industry. As we continue helping our customers set the standard for post-acute and long-term care, we're always looking at expediting our services beyond just workforce management to provide innovative new capabilities. We're thinking across the entire ecosystem that supports post-acute. We're also actively looking at strategic partnerships and acquisitions in the adjacent market over the next 12 to 18 months.
Marina, I want to thank you for sharing your story and the SmartLinks stories. And we wish you luck in the coming years.
Edwin, thank you very much for having me here today.